Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. Here's an email I received, slightly edited for presentation in this video. Hi, I'm Chuni, a senior high school student in the Philippines, grade 11, big fan of yours on YouTube. Can you please solve this? I'm curious about the smallest number for which all numbers 1 to 100 are factors of that number. I assume it has 25 or more digits. I know the method to solve the problem, which is, I've removed this part of the email as it would spoil the puzzle, but my calculator cannot handle such a large number. Can you solve it? Thank you. I did some research and I found the answer online, and the number actually has 41 digits. The number is pronounced 69 duodecillion, 720 undecillion, 375 decillion, 229 nonillion, 712 octillion, 477 septillion, 164 sextillion, 533 quintillion, 808 quadrillion, 935 trillion, 312 billion, 303 million, 556,800. This is a very special number, and the puzzle for you, what is the prime factorization of this number? Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. In general, finding the prime factorization of a large number is a computationally difficult problem. So we're going to solve the problem using elementary number theory. The number n is the least common multiple, or LCM, of all the whole numbers from 1 to 100. So n is the product of the highest power of the primes from 1 to 100. This ensures that every single number from 1 to 100, whatever its prime factorization is, all of those prime factors will be included in n. So we include every prime number that's less than 100. We also need to account if there are repeated prime factors. In order to do that, we find the highest power of each prime that's less than 100. For example, 2 to the 6 is equal to 64. So we need 6 factors of 2 in n. Now, one more factor of 2, 2 to the 7th, would actually be larger than 100. It would be 128. So we do not have 7 factors of 2. Then we have 3 to the power of 4 is equal to 81. The next higher power would be higher than 100. We have 5 squared is equal to 25. 7 squared is equal to 49. And then the next prime, 11 squared, is larger than 100. So we don't have 2 factors of 11. Every other prime that's larger than 11 will have a square that exceeds 102. So we're done checking for repeated prime factors. So these are all the prime factors that are in n. So we can then write n is equal to the product of all these prime factors raised to the highest power that's less than 100. That's 2 to the power of 6, 3 to the power of 4, 5 squared, 7 squared, and then all the other primes, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47, 53, 59, 61, 67, 71, 73, 79, 83, 89, and 97. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions. If you like this video, you can check out my books, which are listed in the video description. You can also support me on Patreon and catch me on social media, either at Mind Your Decisions or at Presh Talwalkar.